Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. We continue with Amarushatakam, which is an anthology of 100 plus poems written by the Sanskrit poet Amaru around the 6th or 7th century AD. The exact times in which Amaru lived and wrote are uncertain, but this work has been mentioned in the literature written in the 8th century AD. Hence, it is safe to assume that Amaru must have preceded these compositions. It is again not certain in which part of India Amaru lived and worked for his livelihood. All that can be said with some certainty is that Amaru's poems were known for their finesse, literary content and craftsmanship. At this point of time, he was often being quoted by other eminent poets and literatures such as Acharya Vaman of the 8th century AD and Acharya Anandavardhan of the 9th century AD. The number of poems going under the name Amaru differs from 100 to around 150. I have selected some for the delight of my listeners. Amaru was a man of the world who had drunk deep the elixir of life and lived by a lover and had seen the lover's life from a close quarter in its various manifestations. He was a poet of great merit. His observations of men and manners, of the beauty of nature, of goings on between lovers, amongst close friends, in the company of the elders or of the strangers, were sharp. He had the words to describe delicate and intimate situations. He had the wit to turn actions of the lovers taken to save their skin into poetic compositions and unforgettable paintings. Amaru believed in lovers coming close to each other, not fighting with each other. In this particular verse which we would be discussing today, a Nayika is being reprimanded by her friend for acting on impulse and insulting her lover in cussed words. The consequences have been made stark clear. Writes Amaru, acting on impulse, you insulted your lover? He, to patch over, had come to your door. He lovingly caressed your feet crawling at the floor. My young and ever-changing friend, your happiness has come to an end. What words? You behaved with haughtiness, arrogance, and now you would pay for all your life, for your misbehavior, for your misdemeanor. Right, Samru, my young and ever-changing friend, your happiness has come to an end. Now lifelong you bear the consequences of your unjust anger and your harsh sentences. You weep and weep to what avail? All your effort is destined to fail. Now these are very strong words, but they are a reprimand to a Nayika from her friend, reprimand for her misbehavior towards her lover, who even came to apologize and she would not listen to him. He crawled at her feet. He caressed them lovingly. She would not budge from your demeanor of haughtiness. What Amaru is trying to tell us is that, look, in human behavior, these things don't pay. Be courteous to each other. Do not use harsh language. As Bhishma Pitamaha said in Mahabharata, words once spoken cannot be taken back. The wound they cause is deeper than that which can be caused by a sword. So all of us in our day-to-day life must weigh the consequences of what we are going to speak. Think before you speak. Look before you leap. The think before you speak is applicable to everybody, including the lovers. They have to be very careful in talking to each other if they are angry. It is all right if lovers are not angry and they are swooning over each other, they are speaking endearments, they are reciting couplets. But once something happens, the railway goes off the track, and if at that time either of them misbehaves and uses foul language, the result, that damage may be irrevocable. That is what Amru says, you weep and weep to what avail, all your effort is destined to fail. We meet again. Thank you very much for listening to me.